Good morning, students. How are you all? I hope you all are fine and safe at home. This is Jyoti Nahar from Shiv Jyoti Educational Group, Kota, and I am going to take class 6 science. And today we will be doing the revision of two chapters, that is chapter 3, fiber to fabric, and chapter 4, sorting materials into groups. So let us start with chapter 3 first. Our chapter 3 is fiber to fabric, and we will be doing the revision of internal questions and the copy work with this. So let us start with the important points of this chapter. The important points of this chapter are: fabrics are made from yarn, which in turn are made from fibers. Now fibers are the thin strands, they are the thin threads which make up fabric, yarn, and yarn is used to make fabrics. Next one, fibers, they are of two types, that is fibers may be synthetic or natural. Now I am going to tell you how these fibers are divided. Like you can see, fibers may be synthetic or they may be natural. Now these natural fibers, they may be divided into two types. They may be obtained from plant sources, that are called plant fibers, and the other one, which are obtained from animals, are known as animal fibers. And the examples of plant fibers are cotton, jute, flax, and the other plant fibers are hemp, sisal, rami, and kapok. Similarly, and animal fibers like silk and wool, these fibers are obtained from animals and thus we call them animal fibers. So we are going to discuss some important fibers like cotton, jute, silk, and wool in detail now. First, we are going to take up cotton. How is cotton produced? Cotton plant grows well in black soil. Black soil is very suitable for cotton plants and it needs a warm climate. It produces a fruit called cotton ball. It has a fruit which is of the shape of a lemon, green fruit, which is called cotton ball. And when this fruit matures, it becomes brown in color and it bursts open. Like you can see in the picture here, it bursts open and the white fibers are exposed. And when these white fibers, they dry in the sun, then the seeds are removed from these fibers and the fibers are separated from the seeds by a process called ginning. So ginning is the process by which the seeds are removed from the fibers of cotton, and then the ginned cotton is pressed into bundles called bales. Ginning is done with the help of hand, with the help of a large comb, or it can be done by machines also. After this, the ginned cotton, this ginned cotton which is having no seeds in it, it is pressed and bundles are formed in it. Then cotton is, what are the uses of cotton? Cotton is soft, comfortable and good absorber of moisture and sweat, and thus it is comfortable for us to wear it in the winter summer season because it absorbs sweat. It has air spaces in between through which the air passes. and it is a bad conductor of heat and electricity. Thus, it is advised to wear cotton clothes in kitchen. While using heat or electricity, we should wear always cotton clothes. The next one is jute. Now, jute is produced from the bark of jute plants. It is the stems of jute plants are used to produce jute. It is mainly grown in West Bengal, Bihar, Assam and Bangladesh. As it needs a lot of water, so it is produced in the mainly in the places where there is lot of rain, like in West Bengal, Bihar, Assam and Bangladesh. And what is the process? The stems of the plants are tied into bundles and they are soaked in water for at least 20 days. And this process is called retting. What happens in retting? The stem is separated from the fibers. During this process, the fibers are separated and afterwards they are washed and dried. A gummy substance which separates the gummy substance is separated and the stems can the fibers can be obtained from the stem by the process of retting. Retting is the process when the stem they are tied into bundles and they are soaked in water for few days so that the fibers can be obtained. And jute is mostly used to make sacks, ropes, carpets, cushions and many packaging materials. The next one that we are going to take up is silk. Now, how is silk obtained? Silk is obtained from the cocoons of silkworm. This silkworm or the larva of the feeds on mulberry leaves, and when it spins a cocoon around itself, and this stage when the larva it wraps itself in the cocoon is called pupa. And this cocoon is boiled in water to kill the silkworms and it is unwound to get silk fibers. As you can see in the picture, these silkworms they are boiled in water and they the silk which is obtained it is unwound from the cocoons and this silk fiber is obtained. So these were the important fibers that we get from plants and animals. Coming back to our important points, our next topic is making yarn from fibers. Spinning is the process which by which we make yarn from fabrics. Spinning can be done with the help of charkhas, simple devices like charkha or takli, but nowadays we use spinning machines for them. Then next process is making fabric from yarn. There are two processes which include making fabric from yarn. They are weaving and knitting. In weaving, two yarns are simultaneously used, means they are used together to make a fabric or a yarn. Two separate yarns are used together. But in knitting, we use a single yarn which is used to make the fabrics like sweaters, mufflers, they are made by the process of knitting. Then we have natural fibers versus synthetic fibers, in which we have the advantages and disadvantages of natural fibers. Like natural fibers are good absorbers of sweat, they keep wool, they keep us warm during the winter season. And synthetic fibers, they are wrinkle free, they dry easily. And the synthetic fibers have disadvantages too. So there is both synthetic fibers are also important as well as natural fibers are also important. So this was about the explanation of the chapter. The descriptive explanation has been given to you in the previous video, so you need to go through them also. Now we are going to discuss the internal questions of this chapter. The first internal question, define fiber. You have to write this internal question on page number 34, and the answer for this you will get on the same page. Like, fibers are very thin threads. When spun, they become thicker and woven into clothes means fibers. They are yarns are made from fibers, and then fabrics are made from yarns. Which is all second question is which is also known as golden fiber. This question you have to write on page number 36, and the answer of this question you will find it in the science bits. The answer is jute. Next question, name good quality wool found in Kashmir. You have to write this question on page number 36, and the answer for this question, the excellent quality of wool which is found in Kashmir, which is obtained from the sheep living in the Kashmir or the Himalayan areas, is Pashmina. Now coming to the copy work of this chapter, the important definitions. The first definition is fabric. Now what is a fabric? The material made by weaving cotton, wool and other natural and synthetic yarns. These yarns, they are woven to get fabrics. Next one is sericulture. Now what is sericulture? Sericulture is the rearing of silkworms for the production of silk, and this rearing is called sericulture, as we discussed how silk is obtained through silkworms. Third one is ginning. What is ginning? As we have discussed in the production of cotton, that a process which is used to separate the cotton fibers from seeds, this process is known as ginning. Coming up to question and answers, the first question, what is meant by silk root? Means what do you call, which root is called the silk root? Now silk, it was traded from China to India, Middle East and Europe, and this route between Asia and Europe, this is known as silk route. Our next question is, give reasons. Cotton clothing is the best clothing for hot and humid climate. Cotton is usually preferred in hot and humid climate. Why? Because it lets air in through the pores. Cotton has pores in between the fibers. So thus sweat can evaporate, it allows air to enter through it, and thus sweat can easily evaporate and our body feels cool, and so it is very comfortable for us to wear it in the summer season. Cotton clothes are easy to wash. Why are cotton clothes easy to wash? Because cotton clothes are good absorbers of water. They absorb water very easily and the water penetrates right to the inside. Cotton clothes are easy to wash because water easily penetrates right to the core of the fibers, and thus they are very easy for washing. Coming up to our long questions, like why are clothes important? Clothes are important for us. Why? Because we wear clothes to protect ourselves from heat, cold and other climatic conditions. They protect us, clothes, they protect us from climatic conditions, like woolen clothes, they protect us from cold. Clothes protect us from minor injuries. Sometimes we get simple injuries, minor injuries, and the clothes that we are wearing, they protect us from these injuries. And clothes, they protect us from insect bites too. Second, third question is, explain the process of making yarn from fibers. How are yarns produced from fibers? The process of making yarn from fibers is called spinning. Spinning is the process from which we make yarn from fibers obtained from plants or from animals. In this process, the fibers are pulled to make them straight and then twisted to make a stronger thread. Means a yarn is made, it may be made from simple devices like charkha or takli, but nowadays we use machines to make yarn. Spinning machines are used to make yarn, in which the fibers, they are pulled out and they are woven or twisted to make strong threads or yarns. Our next question is, explain how jute fiber is obtained from jute plant. Just now, as we discussed the production of jute, how is jute obtained from jute plants? Similarly, we are going to see here, jute fiber is obtained from jute plant in the following ways. We have certain steps for it. The first step includes the stalks of the plants are tied and immersed in water. Jute is obtained from the stem of jute plant, and these stems are collected together, tied, and then they are immersed in water for about 20 days. And this is done to soften the fiber, due to which it is removed from the stalk easily. And this process, where we immerse the stalks of jute in water to obtain fibers from them, is called retting. What happens during retting is, during the sinkage, the gummy substances holding the jute fibers to the stem, there is a sticky substance which holds the stem and the fibers together. And during this retting process, this gummy substance, it rots, and thus we can easily obtain the fibers from them, and the fibers separate out. Then the fourth process here is, the fibers are then washed in clear running water and dried in the sun. After washing and drying in the sun, the fibers of jute are obtained. Next question, we have distinguish between natural and synthetic fibers. There is a table which shows the differences between natural fibers and synthetic fibers. What are the natural fibers are obtained from plants and animals, whereas synthetic fibers are obtained from petroleum products. The second difference is, they are less durable, like cotton. It is less durable as compared to synthetic fibers. They are more durable than natural fibers. The third difference is, they have high water absorbing capacity. That is why they absorb sweat easily. Like cotton, it absorbs sweat. They have less water absorbing capacity. That is why they have less water absorbing capacity. That is why it is generally we like to wear, or we feel cooler in the summer season when we are wearing natural clothes like cotton clothes. The next difference is jute and cotton fibers. The differences between jute fibers and cotton fibers. The first difference, jute fibers are obtained from the bark of Patson plants. The jute plants are Patson plants. Cotton fibers, they are obtained from cotton plants. And in this, the process by which the fibers are obtained is retting. And here, the fibers are obtained by the process of ginning. These are used to make sacks, ropes, carpets, curtains. Especially jute fibers, they are used for packaging materials like sacks, ropes, carpets. These are made. But cotton fibers, these are used to make clothes, absorbent paper, etc.